So here we are at the Art and Music Studios, here with Mr. Shapov, straight from Russia. Thanks Hello. For coming over. A couple of questions for us today. Let's start with the first. You are quite a new name in the electronic music scene. How did you make it happen between all the competitors around the scene?
I think it was like just I did what I love, mm-hmm. and it's happened. The thinking that it's Shapov, it will be Shapov. So I did what I love, so I love my work, and I love to be DJ, I love to play, and it's happened.
That's perfect, man. So, and why are you in Italy, actually, then?
Because I'm playing tomorrow for the event, so that's why I'm here.
Okay, you're playing at the Christmas Calling and yeah, Art and Music Night,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's cool. Correct.
Perfect. So, another question about your past, let's say. Are the Hard Rock Sofa still alive as a project?
Yeah, still alive. Anyway, I focused on Shapov, but Denis, it's my partner in Hard Rock Sofa, so he's working on new music, and hopefully soon it will release something.
We can see something in the future, in the near future. Yeah. That's pretty nice. So, let's keep going. Why did you sign with Axton Record, and how did you meet Axwell?
Oh, so I signed like about 6 years ago, seven, and actually I just sent demo with my first track and ever we released on Accent was Blow Up. Okay. And I was sent to in 2011, I didn't expect Answer, and then we released Quasar, then we released Here We Go, Arms Around Me, and then it starts to shop off, so it's like long time of working.
Okay, I see, man, I see. How did you come up with the Shapov sound? Was it instinctive or it was planned?
I think it was an upgrade to Hard Rock Sofa. It was naturally.
It was naturally coming from
yeah,
you.
Yeah, it's like...
It was not something you planned on the table. It was something instinctive.
Yeah, it was upgrade. It was work of my job, you know, and people who were around me this time, you know. Maybe collaboration stuff, it's like everything, you know.
I see. What do you think about the new dance music worldwide?
I think it's every day it's coming with new artists, so new music and new ideas, everything is developed, and EDM is going to be stronger, bigger, you know, like everything is going up.
It's changing. Do you see a constant changing in the
Yeah,
industry?
Of course, it's every time changing, and I think maybe it's a good way, but I think it's important these days to be original. So.
And for this, do you have any suggestions for the thriving producer, the newcomer producers out there?
Just be yourself.
And just produce by yourself. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. So
it's just not just... produce yourself, be yourself. It's up to you. You can produce with someone, I don't know. Just be with your style yourself.
Okay, I see. So another question connected to this is, many people are asking if it's possible to submit you their production in order to see if you're interested and if it's possible to collaborate with you. Do you think all this process is possible? Like, how does this happen?
Yeah, of course, it's happened if I hear something great on my mail and it sounds great, why not? We can do something together, you know.
Perfect, I see. And tell us about your upcoming releases.
Yeah, in 2017 I have upcoming EP. It will include 4 tracks, so it's gonna be great.
Okay, that sounds great. You cannot give us too much information about it, I think.
Yeah,
right?
It will be EP, it will be cool 4 tracks, and then next year will be a lot of my new releases. So.
Perfect. We're looking forward to this. Then another question about your own country, let's say. Many Russian producers focus on trance music. Why so, in your opinion?
Really?
this sounds new to you?
Yeah, I know some people they focus on it, like Phil Bobina or like, but actually I think it's cool when you have trance sound, but it's a bit upgraded, like Eric Prydz have. It's okay. Really interesting music, in my opinion. That's kind of fresh music.
Okay.
But about Russian trance producers, I don't feel it.
You don't feel that that's true?
No.
At all?
They're good guys, I know them, but music, maybe it's not for me, you know, it's like, totally. It's up to people, you know.
You are now here at the Art and Music Studios, right? And do you think you're going to use this facility to produce some of your track? Are you going to work with the producers here around? I mean, do you have anything planned around that?
Oh yeah, of course, we will work with Bruno here, so we'll see what happened. And I have planned to mix a bit my one of my tracks.
That's nice, that's pretty nice. We're looking forward to that. So tell us about a little bit about yourself. How your life changed in the last couple of years, let's say. How did your life change in the last recent years?
It's changed a lot, you know. I like see that in my life open new ways, you know. It's really great that I did Shapov. It's like from the clean table, you know. Mm-hmm. It's really nice, but you have background and also it's clean table. It's existing time for me, so.
Absolutely. So
it's yeah, it's still like people, it's already 2 years, you know, and it's still people looking, okay, what next? And okay. It's really important to be that people, okay, what next from Shapov? It's really great, you know, like.
People always constantly asking for something new out of it.
Yeah,
okay.
It's like if you like not focus on one stuff, you can make this genre, this genre, this genre. It looks like really cool.
It's amazing, and that's yeah. What you like to do.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that's really nice. And about your performances, do you prepare your DJ set for specifically for the country or the club you're going to play, or it's more something coming out from your vibe?
It's coming, of course, from my vibe, but before the party, of course, I'm preparing and trying to do something interesting in my set, but also I looking around the city and what inspired me for the set and what I feel about this city and what I feel, and I'm trying to do this in the set, and then I play, you know, I see direction, it's like this, you know.
So it's something that comes from the feeling, but from the feeling in the country you are at the moment, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Now, which Italian producers do you know here that, you know, in the EDM music industry?
Italian producers? So I know Merkin Kremot. Mm-hmm. Benny Benassi, of course, of Dr. Shiver, so...
have you ever collaborated with
him? Yeah, I know Simon Dejana guys, and Medwell, I guess, it's two guys there. In the past, long, long time ago, I worked with Nicola Fasana, mm-hmm. his half here. It's a lot of guys here. So, I had some deals before with...
What do you think of the EDM scene in Italy? Like, what do you think of the environment?
It's like building like everywhere. It's building really well.
What do you think, like, EDM? Okay, let's talk about festivals. I'm pretty sure you've been in many festivals already. You've been in huge festivals up in the north of Europe and around the world. What do you think that the sound will change in 10 years from now?
Well, really? I think clubs will still work, but maybe new generation that is coming now, maybe they don't be interesting to go to the club. Maybe it will be different music, I don't know. It depends of new generation which is coming, you know. It's like a difficult question. I don't think that if clubs will still exist, of course, it will be house, you know, it's like
the,
I mean, like, or trap or something, it will be dancing music. But if no clubs, it will be different music. That's my thoughts.
Okay, that's pretty interesting. That's a different point of view from the rest. Being a producer, of course, you have to listen to many genres of music, I would say. What is your preferred genre of music?
I can't say, okay, I love rock. No, really, I love rock. I love what sounds crazy. I can't say I love this genre, this genre, this genre. Okay, I can't listen too much one genre. I love when it's, you know, different kind of music.
You like to move from a different genre once at a time, and especially it depends on the mood mostly sometimes, right?
Yeah, I can't say, okay, this one and enough.
Okay, good to know. So how much is important to promote a new release nowadays, through the social media, through all the channels, and especially how you promote your production?
Of course, it's really important to promote, but of course, if you have big name, I don't know how you built with music or you built with some guys, I don't know, it will be more easy to promote it. But of course, if you have sick music and you don't have actually big partners, but it will promote it, music will promote it by yourself. It will work. But if you have sick music, if you have not sick music, you need partner.
You need someone that helps that.
Yeah, to promote it.
Absolutely, absolutely. Coming back to the environments of festivals and around the world, is there an environment that inspires you the most? Like, for example, I would say, what do you think about the different environments around the world? Does, for example, USA still has a word in the music and festival scene, in your opinion?
I think USA is still pushing Europe with music. Trap, genre, you know, Skrillex, Diplo, Skillz, all heads around the world, that's true. Because I've been in ADE this year, what I saw, I was on writing camps, what I saw, what did young producers, they're trying to copy Snake, Diplo, Skrillex, it's not good. Okay. They're doing really bad things. It doesn't work. They can't be second the Skrillex and Diplo, they can't.
I understand. They always trying to be at the
first. Yeah, and it's a lot of young producers is trying to copy to someone. It's a bad thing.
Of course, I understand. Dear friends, here at the Art and Music Studio is everything with Shapov. We thank you for this interview.
Thank you
very much again. This is Nicola Marogna, and we'll see you the next time.